Something interesting is about the 37th entrant into this race, that is Helen Ekalale from Japan. She's come to Kenya to try seeking get that qualification time. There is Chebet Zena from Uganda, Doreen Chemutai, Doreen Chesang, both from Uganda, each trying to earn that ticket to the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. Remember, these foreign athletes who are coming here, they're all about, they want to get that qualification time. For Kenya, we are going for the number one and number two, and then for the upcoming. So it's very interesting, and it will be very interesting to see how these four foreign athletes in this 10,000 meter start list women final will actually fare on. Na kwa lugha ya Kiswahili kwamba leo tuko hapa Kasarani katika siku ya tatu ya mbio za majaribio za kufuzu katika mashindano ya Tokyo 2020 Olympics, mbio ambazo mashindano ambayo yalianza siku ya Jumatano, hiyo ilikuwa Alhamisi, siku ya Thursday, katika uwanja huu wa Kasarani. Na tumeshuhudia wanariadha wakiwa wakijaribu kufanya mambo ambayo wanaweza kwa kupata ile tiketi ya kufuzu katika mashindano ya Olimpiki, na ni jambo ambalo tumekuwa tukishuhudia hapa kwa saizi. Kwenye runinga yako unatizama wakimbiaji wa mita 10,000, takriban wakimbiaji 37 wako katika mbio hizi, na tutakuwa tunaangazia baadhi ya wachezaji wakimbiaji ambao wanashiriki hapa. Kuna Agnes Tirop, kuna Rosemary Wanjiku wa Prisons, Helen Obiri ambaye alishinda fedha katika mashindano yaliyopita kule Rio, alafu kuna Irene Kipchumba Kimas wa KDF. Lakini la muhimu pia, kuna wanariadha kutoka nchi za kigeni, watatu kutoka kule Uganda na mmoja kutoka kule Japan, ambao pia tutakuwa tunaangazia. Back to you, Charity, as the race begins.
Yeah, as the 10,000 meters ladies go on, the javelin also is going on. So far we have Julia Siego, who has already qualified. There will be also Alex Kiprotich of KDF. He'll be trying to look for a ticket. There is also a young man coming up, Leshan Itanao. Itanao is also the African youth champion. He is a man, the athlete that wants to retake the mantle after Yego retires. So we are looking forward to see, because the standards for throwing that right now, you have to have an 85 meter throw. Tunasubiri wakati wote sasa kuona mbio za mita 10,000 zikianza. Hapa pia kuna mwanariadha Sandra Felix Chebet. Sandra pia ni mwanariadha chipukizi katika mbio za wanariadha walio na umri wa miaka chini ya umri wa miaka 20. Mwingine pia wa kuangalia ni Sheila Kipchumba.
Mbio za mita 10,000 ndizo zinaanza finali ya kina dada katika uwanja wa Kasarani. Na kutoka hapa ni tiketi mbili za kwanza. Wale wanariadha ambao walimaliza katika nafasi mbili za kwanza watapata tiketi ya moja kwa moja kwenda katika mashindano ya Olimpiki yatakayokuwa kule Japan kuanzia mwezi ujao. Kisha nafasi ya tatu itapewa chipukizi ambaye atakuwa ameweka muda bora zaidi, na pia kuna wanariadha wa nchi za kigeni ambao wamekuja kujaribu kupata ile nafasi bora. Kumbuka nafasi dakika 31 na sekunde 25 ndio wakati ambao umewekwa na IOC wa kufuzu katika mashindano ya 10,000 meters katika kitengo cha kina dada.
Sheila Chipkiroe pia she has a silver in the cross country that was held in Yaounde, Cameroon. She also finished 7th during the London World Championships. I think right now she has the experience of 42 times to be an Olympian. She'll be looking forward to getting her ticket. So far, the park is still intact. Being a fast slower, the first lap is a bit slower. We are hoping to see it becoming faster as the race progresses.
Yeah, definitely, because you look at how the men raced yesterday, that was on Friday. You see, it was close together until the last four laps, when we started seeing the likes of Kimoi and the likes of Geoffrey Kwamoror tearing away the park and ensuring that they seek the first two positions, which enabled them to qualify for the Olympics. Remember, Kwemoi is Kwamoror's training partner, so it feels good to have both of them at the Olympics in the 10,000 meters. Both of them training together, they're like brothers. It reminds me of the other day on Thursday when we saw the two brothers, they call themselves brothers, that is Marco Tieno and Ferdinand Omanyala, saying that this was one of the best races they've raced together, and they hope that it becomes even better as they prepare for the Olympics.
Yeah, and also there's another athlete from the Global Sports Communication team. There is Joshua Cheptegei, is also one of them. So we're looking forward to see how it is going to be, Kangaroo versus Cheptegei. Those are my the favorites. I'm really looking forward to see how that will be.
Definitely, and you can see that the competition, and in the first early stages of this race, Ohelen Obiri setting the pace, ensuring that she stays in the front pack. This is her style. This is how she likes running, from the front, not behind. Over the years, you've seen Obiri doing that. We saw that in the during the World Championships in Doha, where she ran in front from the first lap to the last lap. Is this a good tactic, if you may ask?
One has to believe in their training system. We have to know how it goes, and we have our media organizer here, over here, Michael Okinyi, just checking and ensuring that we are all following the COVID protocols as we prepare for the World Under 20 Championships.
Definitely, all protocols have been observed, as we can put it. I can see most of these photographers and cameramen, and including the other members of the media, are really trying hard to ensure that everything is intact, everything is perfect. And there we go, into the third lap. It's been a bit slower as predicted, because not everyone wants to show the tactics early on, but they're just trying to ensure that they are within touching distance of each other. You can see Ohelen Obiri still leading the final day of the Kenya Olympic Games trials right here at Kasarani. Kwa lugha ya Kiswahili ni kwamba leo tuko katika uwanja wa Kasarani kwa siku ya mwisho ya mashindano ya kufuzu kwa Olimpiki, na ni mashindano ambayo ilianza siku ya Alhamisi, yakaendelea hapo jana, na leo yanakamilika mida ya saa 7:30 tutakapojua ni nani atakayekuwa na peperusha bendera ya taifa katika mashindano ya Olimpiki kule Japan, mashindano ambayo yanaanza tarehe 23 mwezi Julai, na ni mashindano ambayo yaliahirishwa baada ya ile janga la corona ambalo limekuwa jinamizi kubwa haswa katika michezo na hali zingine. Tukiangalia wakimbiaji hawa wakija katika ile awamu ya 4, mzunguko wa 4 wa mashindano haya ya mita 10,000 kwa kina dada, tunaona mwanadada Ohelen Obiri hataki kuachwa nyuma, ako pale mbele kabisa, anang'ang'ana kama kawaida yake kuhakikisha kwamba hawachwi nyuma, maanake wajua kwamba ukiwachwa nyuma basi inakuwa ni vigumu sana kujumuika na wengine. Sasa hivi tunaona kidogo ule Mganda ako pale nyuma, Mganda Chebet Zena ako pale nyuma, lakini wale wengine wote wako katika nafasi nzuri. Kwa sasa hivi hatujajua ni nani atakaye kuwa na uwezo wa kushinda mbio hizi.
Katika mbio hizi, Obiri, unakumbuka pia amekimbia mbio za marathon, half marathon, na aliweza kushinda kwa sababu endurance yake, alisema endurance iko sawa. She was happy with the 5,000 meters, the time she clocked in the 5,000 meters. For here, because they're going for 24 laps, maybe they will be conservative with the first few laps for them, because going around this field 24 times is not going to be easy.
It's not easy. It's not easy at all, because you look at the... They've also been progressing in the last 2 days, preparing for this day. So it's tough. So endurance and then the resilience is what they need heading into the sixth lap. As we can see, Obiri doesn't want to be left behind. She's really, really, really trying hard to ensure that she stays with the leading pack. And right now, Rosemary Wanjiru is the one leading, and Obiri in the second position.
Sheila Chepkiroyo is also believing in herself. She's keeping up tabs with Obiri. She also desperately wants to make that happen. And up next, after the 10,000 women's race, is the men 1500. event. We have our favorite, Timothy Cheruiyot, the world champion. Timothy didn't make it during the Rio Olympics. This one is going to be his first race, his first Olympics also. There is George Metamei Manangoi. He's a younger brother to Elijah Manangoi, the former world champion. Manangoi is also the world under 18 champion that was held at Kasarani. He also recently graduated from KDF. He's now a Navy officer. There's also Ronald Kwemui. Ronald Kwemui is also a tough guy to beat. There's Vincent Kibet, Chelsea Muoto, Abel Kipsang taking on. Yeah, I can see Sheila is now taking the lead. Obiri sitting back at the fourth place. Everything is going quite on well. The field has been tiered into three groups so far. And things are going to get tough here.
The weather also, you can see a drastic change in the weather pants. It means that right now it's your endurance that will make you try and earn that qualification, because you can see they are slowing down a little bit. The athletes are slowing down a little bit, and it makes it easier for one who's prepared well to try and break out from the rest of the pack. As we can see right now, Dorcas Kipchumba Kimeli leading the pack at the moment on that bend. Dorcas Kipchumba leading. You are talking about the 1500 meters, and you can see seven athletes are within qualification time as it stands. And you can see everyone giving a round of applause for Sheila Chepkurui Kiprotich, who's now taking the mantle. And look at them. Obiri still trying to ensure that she stays with the leading pack, but then it started shaping up at the moment, as you can see.
Yeah, Obiri decided to take charge of the races so that she can push the pace of the race so that it will not be that slower. She's also looking to test her training against the high altitude at the Kasarani, which is above 1800 meters above sea level. We're looking forward as we go on. Yes. Yesterday, on Thursday, I spoke to Diego. He said he's looking forward, if he can be able to upgrade his Olympics silver medal from Rio to a gold, that will be the best moment for him. But he's taking it easy, hoping to make another 90th row and above for him to be among the medal prospects in the Olympics. As for Adams, his strategy is throwing about 85. His main target right now is to qualify, because guys, the Germans are throwing 90 and above, first and second throws. So the standards in the javelin have been set quite high. And then there is the young guy, Itanao. Itanao made his name known during the World Under 18 events over here at the Kasarani. Itanao has been preparing quite well. He's also a high school student, and hoping that he will be able one day to be at the level of the Germans in throwing javelin.
Exactly, and you can see the qualification time for the javelin men final is 85 meters, and out of that, only Alex Toroitich, Kiprotich, is coming close to Yego's time. Alex has has thrown 77.18 meters. Yego, 87.3. And you just talked about them setting standards. You could see Yego was one of the people who set standards. That's 4 years ago. Right now, everyone is looking forward to being like Yego. And you can see these young javelin throwers coming in. It shows you that there's that resilience and will to maybe match up what Yego has done. And you can see the athletes. Sheila still leading the pack. Obiri coming in second position. The 10,000 meters is slowly taking shape. Right now, the field has been separated into the leading pack and then the chasing pack, slightly behind, like 20, 30 meters behind the leading pack. And this is something that we are witnessing right here at Kasarani Stadium, the final day of the Kenya National Olympic Trials. And after today, the squad to represent Kenya will be selected right here at around 1:30 p.m. East Africa time after the completion of the day's program. Remember, after the 10,000 meters women, there is the final of the 1,500 meters men, where we have 16 entrants with 7 already in the qualification time. That is 3 minutes 35 seconds. And it's Timothy Cheruiyot from Prisons leads the pack. He's posted a time of 3 minutes 28.77 coming into this race. George Manangoi from KDF with a time of 3:31.25. But then there we go. The 11th lap, that is Sheila still leading. Obiri coming in close and ensuring that she stays with Sheila. Remember, Sheila is from KDF and has came into this race with a time of 30 minutes 45.01 seconds. That was the national anthem just to kickstart the day officially. And the 10,000 meters women final is still underway. As you can see in your screens, the athletes have already, the leading pack has already decided this is what you want to do. They are leading all the way. Sheila still leading Obiri, coming into that bend, the stretch that everyone fears. It's the final stretch when the race comes to an end. But then this is the 12th lap. They're coming to cross here at a time of 13 minutes and 38 seconds. That is the 12th lap. And it's really, really close. 9 athletes in the leading pack. You don't know who's going to take it. Nine athletes in the leading pack. Sheila Chepkurui Kiprotich leading Helen Obiri. And then there is Dorcas Jepchumba Kimeli also coming in close. But then it's taking shape, Charity. It's what we expected halfway.
Yeah, this racing at a high altitude is never that easy. That's why several world events, they are held at a lower sea level. That's why you'll see, I think I can only be able to say who is the top, maybe for a surprise, but I think Obiri will be there. And I can see Sheila, she's still hanging in there. And now it's the fight for the third place. You have to be safe, depending with the time that you're going to clock in. So far, 2 athletes have dropped out, and it's going to be brutal. I expect more to drop out. Oh, and also there is another one.
And Obiri taking the lead right now. She's decided this is what we want to do right now. She's leading the race, closely followed by Sheila, who's now dropped to the third position. But then this is a very close field. No one can say that there's a clear favorite right now.
Yeah, Daisy and Sheila, they're still hanging around Obiri. They're ensuring that akikanyaga hapa tuko na yeye hapa kwa hapa bumper to bumper.
Bila shaka bumper to bumper, tukienda katika mzunguko wa 14 ambapo Helen Obiri kwa sasa hivi amechukua usukani, ako katika nafasi ya kwanza katika mbio hizi za mita 10,000 kwa kina dada. Kumbuka hii ni finali ya mbio hizi ambapo nafasi mbili za kwanza, wale ambao watakaoshinda watachukua ama kupewa tiketi ya moja kwa moja kuwakilisha nchi hii katika mashindano ya Olimpiki yatakayofanyika kuanzia tarehe 23 mwezi Julai pale Tokyo, Japan. Kiangalia kwa sasa hivi ule mganda kidogo yamemlemea.
Na anaenda kuzungukwa, itakuwa mara ya pili yeye kwenda kuzungukwa na kina Obiri. So katika sheria za riadha anafaa kizungukwa akimbilie kwenye leni ya nje na si yeye peke yake. Ekale pia atakuwa akizungukwa.
Ekale amezungukwa na inaonyesha kwamba kuna upinzani mkali sana hapa katika mashindano haya. Lakini ukiangalia kwa sasa hivi Helen Obiri ndiye anayeongoza katika kile kikundi cha kwanza cha wale wanariadha ambao wanakimbia katika mbio hizi za mita 10,000 za kina dada. Kumbuka ni finali ambayo inafanyika hapa katika uwanja wa Kasarani. Tumekuwa hapa tangu siku ya Alhamisi. tumekuwa hapa kuanzia siku ya Alhamisi na tumeshuhudia mambo mengi yakifanyika, rekodi zikivunjwa, mwanariadha kadhaa kukatwa matumaini ya kuwasilisha kuwakilisha nchi yao katika mashindano ya Olimpiki, na tunaona mwanariadha mwingine amesalimu amri, mambo maji yamezidi unga. Na anapigiwa makofi pale.
Pia ni kujaribu sana. Katika for some of the athletes that have already booked their tickets to Tokyo, include in the 100 meters men, it includes Ferdinand Omanyala and Marco Tieno. In the 400 women, we have a sprinter this time round. There is Helen Siumbua. And then in the 400 meters men hurdle, we have Moitalel Mpoke. He is US-based. He'll join Team Kenya ahead there. And then in the 5,000 meters women, we have Helen Obiri and Lillian Kasait. They have already booked their tickets. In the 10,000 meters men, we have Geoffrey Kipsang-Kamuror and Ronald Koimui. Hopefully, maybe if everything goes well for Ronet, he might be given the third slot. And then in javelin, we only have one so far, Diego. Hopefully, Alexander or Itanao might surprise us also.
Definitely, we hope Alexander will surprise us, but it's really, really tough if you look at how the qualification process has been grueling for these athletes. As you can see, right now, the leading pack has been reduced to seven athletes, and that shows you that it's been very, very competitive. It's quite fast than we anticipated. They started off slowly, but right now you can see the athletes know that every step they take forward means that they are getting closer to earning that ticket to the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. And coming in with Sheila also trying really hard not to stay away from Obiri, who looks like a clear favorite here.
Yeah, but Sheila looks comfortable. There's a little surge over there so that they can be able to overtake the other athlete who is being lapped for the third time. There's an also the Ugandan is still hanging on here. It's quite impressive with this altitude. They are hoping to join Akina Cheptegei and the rest in the Ugandan team. And actually, there is the uprise of the Uganda. Mostly we make fun of it and call. We say it's Kenya B because most of them are our sisters from and brothers from Mount Elgon. We are happy.
The likes of Joshua Cheptegei.
Yes, and Stephen Kiprotich.
Yes.
Yeah. Stephen also won a gold medal at the Olympics. And during Rio, he trained alongside Eliud Kipchoge at Kaptagat. People were worried that he might be able to defend his title and deny Eliud the gold medal. However, Eliud proved his master. He was not afraid of competition. He trained with competition and took it easy and even set an Olympic record.
Exactly, and Obiri clearly showing that she's also the mistress in this race. Look at how she's controlling this. It's clear that she's still energized for this. And coming into second position at the moment is Rosemary Wanjiru. She's like she's not giving up easily, and she knows that she has a chance to maybe match Obiri. And you can see Obiri clearly making sure that she stays clear of the chasing lot right now, with around 3-4 meters ahead of them. And this might be Obiri's double. Bridget Kosgei there, she's really been strong. I think she's coming back after some time out, and we've seen the devastating effects of athletes that have the effect that have I can put it, the effects of this kind of altitude to athletes who are coming back from, let's say, injury or long layoffs.
Some of the notable athletes that have dropped at the back is Sheila Chepkirui, Sandra Felis. Now the pack is among only four athletes. In a short while, we'll be able to know who are in the leading pack, but Helen is already at the front. Sandra is also trying hard to keep, Sheila, she's trying hard to keep up. Sandra looks like she'll still have to try again next year. And we have, so far we have about four athletes that have gone out of the race. We think with the fewer competition in Africa, it really affected them, because at this time round, when you were preparing for Olympics, most athletes qualify. A lot of them qualify. And then you are unable to know who is the race favorite. And the Diamond League also starting.
Often, that was Bridget.
Bridget is also has fallen back. I also feel it's quite unfortunate for her also. But I think everything is going to go on well later. Maybe for the next Olympics, it will be good for Paris.
That will be like, that's 8 years from now. I wonder if Bridget will still be racing anyway. But looking at this, Obiri still leading with Rosemary closing by. Remember, it's the 10,000 women final that is taking place right here at Kasarani Stadium. It's been 3 days of action that ends today at around 1:30 p.m. With several events expected, and the final list of athletes who will be representing the country in the 2020 Tokyo Olympics being presented officially, and we hope that we'll see some of the big names making it into the squad. Right now, it's all about the 10,000 meters women final that is currently underway. The field has really been separated. If you're not keen, you cannot know who's leading who and who is in which position. You have to be keen enough, but as usual, we'll always give you the best. We'll always give you who is leading, and you can see right now Obiri coming in. She's still energetic. It shows you that she has that capability of even running better and with a better time. Margaret Chelimo Kipkemboi has also moved into fourth position right now. She's from National Police Service, but Helen Obiri is still leading. Margaret Chelimo Kipkemboi, right now, she's moved to fourth position. This is one person we've not really talked about.
Cheptai, Chelimo, and Obiri among the favorites. We'll know who is going to clinch the title, what is going to go where.
Helen Obiri there, leading the rest of the pack. I can see Chelimo moving into third position. Clearly, it's Obiri is trying hard to ensure that right now, look at that right now, Obiri making sure that she leads the rest of the pack. She's breaking away. She's breaking away right now. 6-7 meters ahead of second place. Wow. She is making a statement here, Obiri.
Yeah, they're about to get to the bell right now. I'm looking forward to hear what she's going to be saying at the interviews. Because now it's either Irene or Sheila who will be going for the second place. It's a competition. You know, you have to secure everything. You have to be 1-2.
You say you throw everything within your disposal to ensure yes. that you earn that ticket. And Obiri is clearly doing that.
Yes.
You can see she's not giving up. She's still energized. She finished second in the 5,000 meters trial. But she said that was just the beginning. Look at this right now.
Yes, she was conserving energy for this event.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And you know this is her speciality.
Yeah, the most important thing was to qualify, nothing more. And then when she goes back to training for the roughly 35 days remaining, she can be able to know where.
Sadly, Margaret Chelimo has fallen. And she was in fourth position. It's so unfortunate.
It's brutal.
Over here. Because she was really, really into the race. She was occupying fourth place. But then I think maybe the speed of Obiri and the standards she set are just way too high for some of these athletes. Look at her right now, breaking away from the rest of the pack, making, that's like 50 meters ahead of second placed Chelimo. She's a star. She is a star. She just shows you that she's looking for, let's say, the gold medal. Look at her. Not like, wow, look at Helen Obiri. She looks energized. She's determined. Heading into the last laps of this race. Yes, in second place. And definitely, as it stands, she's the one who will finish second in this race. I don't see much changes happening in this race. Still fighting for the third place. Is yes, the orange bib. We all know what, yes, you all know what Mike, they like such kind of attire.
Yeah, you see, you have to make your brand visible. Yeah. Colors, brighter ones.
Wow, and another athlete has fallen off the park. This weather has really, really, yes, yes.
That's why you have to be conservative.
Exactly, and the last turn of events, as we head into the last few laps of this race. Now we have
about 12 of
them. There 12 remaining.
Things are tough.
Yes, things are tough.
She's expecting to die.
Yes.
She's holding on. She doesn't mind. Shayla, she's comfortable. She's at the back. I'm happy that she's not getting into the pressure of trying to make it.
Yes, and Irene Chebet Cheptai from North Rift. The personal best of 30.51. That is 30 minutes, 51 seconds. This race has just shown us the quality that we have, especially the from the likes of Helen Obiri. We've seen Yego posting some good times in the javelin. I think we shall be confirming that in a while. But then, other meters, it started with 30.
My representer Zia.
But right now, the field has been reduced to around 5. Helen Obiri leading the way.
At the same time, too much young women is going on. Javelin win now, Yego is there. There is Yego. The YouTube man. Kengele ni hero is out. Kengele ni hero. Kengele ni hero. Natika Hishri Natisa. Nafazi ya pili Erin Jeptai. Nafazi ya tatu Shaila Chelaga. Nafazi ya Nancy Chelaga. Aya. Kumbuka muda wa kufusu. Natika 31 sekunde 25.
Natika 29 sasa.
Kumbuka hapo ni tatu na bila shaka ataingia ndani. Yeye hai. Wow.
Tusubiri tuone, tusubiri tuone basi.
Ni hapa. 250 meters go now. Helen Obiri. Coming for the last 200 meters now. Anakuja ile mita 200 ambayo imesalia sasa. Mita 200 tuwashangilie sasa. Helen Obiri ndio huyo. Tuwapigie makofi tafadhali. Helen Obiri anakuja sasa, taking the home stretch. Aya, anakuja Helen Obiri, anakuja Helen Obiri ndio huyo. Irene Cheptai, Helen Obiri ndio huyo. Kuna fimbo, Helen Obiri anashika mshindi. Kuna fimbo anashika mbili. Irene Cheptai,
Irene Cheptai, 360.
Irene Cheptai ndio huyo sasa, 360. Shaila Chelagat, Nancy, Irene Cheptai, hata yeye ameingia.
Nakwambia dakika 30 mwenzangu, dakika 30 sekunde 53.60, na kumbuka muda wa kufuzu ni dakika 31 sekunde 25. Mambo sawa.
53.60. That is the time done by Helen Obiri.
I tell you.
Irene Cheptai, under the qualifying mark,
come rain, come sunshine. So Tishaila Chelagat and so to Nancy Chelagat also, my colleague.
Basi kama vile mambo ilivyokuwa ni kwamba mwanariadha kutoka KDF Hellen Obiri, bingwa wa nyika, bingwa ulimwengu, amewafurahisha mashabiki hapa. Naweza kuona mashabiki, baadhi ya mashabiki, tuna volleyballers wetu ambao wataelekea katika michezo ya Olimpiki kule Japan.
Bridget Kosgei ndio huyo sasa anakuja kumaliza vizuri sana. The Olympic the marathon record holder.
Kumbuka mwenzangu nikiwa hapa chini